We use words every day. We write them, we see them, and most importantly, we hear them. For many, we listen to people we consider idols, listening carefully to the words and the stories they share with us. We say figures like Shakespeare are obsolete in our society because the words they wrote are outdated and don't apply to us now. The importance of these figures does not lie in the words, but something much deeper within them, the message. This brings me to the focus of the video, Kendrick Lamar.
All's my life I has to fight, nigga. All's my life I, hard times like, yeah. Bad trips like, yeah. Nazareth, I'm fucked up, homie, you fucked up. But if God got us, then we gon' be all.
The Compton-born, proud African-American rapper, who is one of the world's most respected and appraised figures. See, Lamar isn't infatuated with money, glamour, or fame. His love for rap stands in the words he speaks and the message he sends. Lamar lived a life on the outside of gangs, violence, and drugs. He admits often that he was not only a witness. In fact, he often shares stories of his youth to teach the next generation from his mistakes. For example, the song The Art of Peer Pressure, about his changing character when he's with his friends. On the intro, he states multiple times that he's a good kid, but he can't speak for himself when he's with his friends. He uses these songs to educate not only those living in Compton, but all those who listen to him. The special trait Kendrick holds is his ability to relate to all audiences. His lyrics are deep for those who love the story he tells, but also his flow on the lines gives entertainment for those who enjoy the sound. Regardless of how much the individual listener cares about the lyrics, they still understand the basic message. Lamar tackles issues that relate to him or his childhood directly. Topics like racism, gang violence, drugs, depression, and fame are the theme of some of his most powerful songs to date.
So when you hear these stories in Good Kid, Mad City, when you hear these stories in To Pimp a Butterfly, it's a little bit deeper than just the music. It's cats out here really trying to do something and really trying to spark the idea of positivity in the community.
Whether he speaks for himself on the track or through the eyes of a family member or friend, he uses multiple perspectives to show his understanding of the issue. It's one of Lamar's most iconic traits, in that even if you listen to a Kendrick Lamar song, it may not actually be Lamar rapping. On Sing About Me, I'm Dying of Thirst, Lamar's three main verses switch from the perspective of his good friend who recently lost a brother to violence, a young girl who scolds Lamar for speaking his opinion about prostitution and young women, and an introspective Lamar. The song's beauty is that it links three almost separate topics into one theme, the idea of dying without sharing your story. As said before, this is one of Lamar's most iconic traits. His consistency to bounce from character to character to better explain a story shows how wise he is as a storyteller. There are many examples of Lamar utilizing his memories and those of his friends and family to make a statement. However, his most passionate songs are about his background of an African American. Lamar grew up in the mean streets of Compton. His early life was full of exposure to poverty and violence, something he's not proud of seeing, but he's still thankful that he avoided becoming consumed in the dangerous lifestyle. Lamar cares deeply about the treatment of African Americans in America, and uses his influence to shed light furthermore on the important topic. However, Lamar is not afraid to show the negatives that his culture holds. In the song Black or the Berry, he exposes his anger held for Trayvon Martin, who was innocently killed in 2012. Lamar compliments his anger for discrimination by pondering the question, is it alright if a black man kills another black man? He calls himself a hypocrite for crying because of the death of Martin while his culture continues to kill each other.
So why did I weep when Trayvon Martin was in the street when gangbanging make me kill a nigga blacker than me? Hypocrite.
The idea that one side of an argument can't be stronger than the other without the knowledge of both sides is something that shows Lamar's understanding of these issues. Another important piece in Lamar's music is his influence, an idea he carries through the entirety of his 2015 album, To Pimp a Butterfly. Through the album, a poem recited by Lamar is spoken at the end of each song. As the music progresses through the album, more of the poem is revealed until the final track where Lamar recites the entirety of the poem. The poem reflects his personal struggles, his life after fame haunted by mistakes. In the poem, he talks about his influence. As a rapper, Kendrick Lamar's words get heard by millions of people every day. This power of influence, he misuses to get revenge. He recites in the poem,
I remember you was conflicted, misusing your influence. Sometimes I did the same.
The following track, These Walls, explains the story of how he abused his fame as a rapper to get revenge on the man who killed his friend's brother. The song highlights a scene from his memories, the night he used his status to hurt, and Lamar is not proud of this, but he understands what he did is not unjustified. Using the powerful message to teach not only his audience, but himself also. The most powerful line in the song is where Lamar says, "So when you play the song, rewind the first verse about me abusing my power so you could hurt, about me and her in the shower whenever she horny, about me and her in the hours of the morning." Another amazing song, for its raw dissection of Lamar's true thought, is the song You, the inverse of the peppy, feel-good song I. You tackles depression, more or less the survivor's guilt Lamar feels after leaving Compton, as well as the weight on his shoulder that have caused him to turn to vices to avoid the reality of the truth. In the song, Lamar is drunk to the point where he's sipping from his bottle between verses. The idea that money can't buy away depression is the harsh final line of the song. And if I told your secrets, the world or no money can't stop a suicidal weakness. The ideology that fame brings happiness is immediately dismissed by Lamar as he reveals his darkest pains that money, alcohol, and isolation failed to help. Topics like these shed light into issues everyone can relate to. The words Lamar chooses to say resonate within those who can sympathize with his message. Lamar often turns to God in deep reflection, a theme that continuously appears in his music from the last couple years. The concept of talking to a godlike figure is not exactly a revolutionary idea in music. However, the figure Lamar uses to symbolize God is what makes the theme of religion in his music so interesting. Lamar uses God as a character that watches him, a mentor, or even a spectator. In his darkest times, Lamar asks this figure for help, or advice, but becomes dismissed and ignored, and even scolded for his actions. The thing is, when Lamar uses a godlike figure in his music, he always puts himself below the figure. It creates a relationship where Lamar is always forced to find the answer himself, because his questions are always left unanswered. On the contrary, to his representation of God's silent judgment is the intrusive and illustrious devil, or Lucifer, who tries to deceive Lamar into trusting him. Lucy go fill your pockets. Lucy go move your mama out of Compton inside the gigantic mansion like I promised. Lucy just wants your trust and loyalty. Avoiding me? It's not so easy. I'm at these functions accordingly, Kendrick. Lucy don't slack a minute. So on one hand, God takes the form of a powerful presence that Lamar fears, while Lucifer takes the shape of a friend who is very persistent to gain his trust. These ideas of a balance between good and evil in Lamar's music shows his ability to weave religious ideas into music that the audience may not even realize is about religion. Regardless of backgrounds or belief, the music's message carries the same ideas over. Even if you don't follow the religion Lamar believes in, the meaning is still relevant. When Kendrick Lamar writes a song, he isn't just thinking about an issue that others want to hear. His music stems deep from within. And by using his ability to share personal reflections into a 4-minute song, he's able to spread a message that we need to hear. To call Lamar the voice of this generation is too generous. In fact, there are a lot of issues he has yet to voice his opinion on. Lamar's power lies in his ability to use his life as a support for his message, using personal pains and beliefs as a way to fortify his ideas and show he cares. The idea that Lamar's music will be obsolete in the future, in the same ways as Shakespeare is to us, is something Kendrick understands. Even if his words are forgotten, the stories he shared and the people who he inspired will continue his legacy long past his time.